It started as a department in 1986. We branched out from medicine when one of our heads, the first one who founded the department, Dr. Maman Chandi, actually started the department. Since then, we have moved forward in a big way in terms of trying to offer world standard of treatment for hematological disorders for patients in India, as well as focus on a number of research questions which helps us in making treatment options better for patients in India. We have grown up to a large department. We have more than 200 people working in our department. We have a large number of inpatients, approximating about 90 on an average in the wards. And we do a large number of transplants. Even we're probably the largest bone marrow transplant center in the country as of now. So we do a lot of transplants for a number of diseases which are both malignant and non-malignant, and diseases which are sort of very peculiar to the Asian population. For example, thalassemia major, which is not seen much in the West. Our results with these diseases are as good as what happens in the West. We are able to achieve cure rates of 70 to 80% in thalassemia. We are able to achieve cure rates of 70% in aplastic anemia. With malignancies like acute lymphoblastic leukemia and acute myeloid leukemia, we are able to achieve cure rates of 40 to 50%, which are probably very similar to the data that is available from Western countries. And importantly, we are able to do it at a cost which is much lower than what happens in the West. The average cost of a transplant at our center would roughly be, if you put it in US dollars, about $20,000 to $25,000, while if you go to the West, it would anywhere be between $75,000 to $100,000. So for a fraction of the cost, we are able to do transplants and achieve results which are very similar to what you would get out in the West. So we are steadily building up the department. We started with a 3-bedded transplant unit, and now we have gone up to a 10-bedded transplant unit. We do roughly about 14 to 15 transplants per year, per month, which means roughly about 200 transplants in a year. We are planning to, hopefully in the next few years, we are planning to move over to a 30-bedded transplant unit, which will make that the number of volumes will actually go up. One of our major difficulties that we have is that even though our cost is still small as compared to the West, the cost is still high when you look at an Indian population and you look at the salary that an Indian population gets. So our main focus has been to try and see where we can get donors from who will be willing to contribute to help poor patients get a good transplant. We have had help from the Prime Minister's office, the Chief Minister's office, and foundations like the Ratan Tata Foundation, who have actually helped us in subsidizing the cost of transplant. So we have been focusing on a lot of areas which basically look at trying to understand the disease in India, as well as try to understand how we can make treatment cheaper. So one of the major areas where we have managed to do well is in a disease called as acute promyelocytic leukemia, where initially the standard of treatment was with a drug called at all-trans retinoic acid, or ATRA. And the problem with that drug was that it was very costly. It used to cost about 6 to 8 lakhs for the entire treatment, which meant that more than 80% of our patients who were potentially curable had to be turned away because they could not afford the treatment. With basic clinical research, we were the first in India and almost first in the world after the Chinese to actually introduce the concept of using arsenic trioxide in the treatment of acute promyelocytic leukemia, and we managed to bring the cost down from 6 to 8 lakhs to about 1 to 1.5 lakhs, and because of that, we have more than 80 to 90% are getting treated. In addition, a lot of diseases like acute myeloid leukemia, diseases like chronic myeloid leukemia, we are able to study the biology of the disease and try and look for new targeted therapies. In the field of bleeding disorders and in the field of thalassemia, we are able to offer a wide range starting from diagnosis to antenatal counseling and antenatal diagnosis of thalassemia to go up to prevention of thalassemia and treatment of thalassemia major. So I think the biggest challenge in the clinic is how we can get affordable clinical care. Unfortunately, treatment of hematological disorders is costly, and it is out of the reach of a large number of patients who come to us, and it's a big challenge for us to try and mobilize money from the government sector, from the private sector, to try and help these patients. Our aim would be to try and see that each and every patient who walks through our department can get quality treatment, which would be the standard of care anywhere in the world. That, I think, is the biggest challenge. The second challenge which we face and which we do on a daily basis is to try and see what are the treatment options that we can offer which are unique for our country, which will help in reducing and subsidizing the cost of the treatment, at the same time making sure that it is effective in curing the disease. I think the future is very bright. Hematology is a very nascent subject in the country. We had a situation about 10 years back where there were probably about 5 transplant centers around the country. Now it's growing up to 30 to 40 transplant centers which are available, which essentially means that there are a lots more of hospitals which are available where patients can go for cure. In a large number of areas, we would say we are at par with what happens in the West, both in terms of diagnosis and in terms of treatment of malignancies, but there are lots more that we can do. Cellular therapy is probably something which we are hoping we can bring into the future in the treatment of hematological malignancies. Gene therapy is the other place that we are looking at, which we hope will add on to the armamentarium of stem cell transplantation, by which we can offer cure to almost all patients who come to us for treatment.